Yes, after denying Tinubu as his godfather, Fashola finally agrees, accepts, and says nothing bad with godfatherism. I mean, it's a common word we've come to terms with in Nigeria among politicians, especially in the Lagos Axis, the southwest region of the country. We as Shiwaju Ahmed Bola Tinubu, I mean, whether you like it or not, to a large extent, controls the political arena terrain of that state. As Shiwaju Ahmed Bola Tinubu, since 1999, he became a democratic elected governor. And since he left, he has still been ruling Lagos State by proxy. I mean, so much so that he has his people there, and you must follow the rule, law, and order for you to be able to stay in power. We've seen it happen again and again. If you bend the rules, there is no need to reinvent the wheel because he has already put a wheel in place. You just come in and you follow suit. As soon as you try to reinvent the wheel, that the system has changed, we should do something else. Guess what? Tinubu kicks you out. And so, Fashola, many people have said that Tinubu is your godfather. The guy said, no, he's not my godfather. But God, guess what? At last, Ogoro, don't jump. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up, subscribe if this is your first time. Thank you. Yes, after denouncing Tinubu as his godfather, Fashola finally accept, says nothing bad with godfatherism. Years after denying the leader of the All Progressive Congress, Shiwaju Ahmed Bola Tinubu, as his godfather, Minister of Works and Housing Babatunde Fashola says there is nothing wrong with having a political godfather. Yes, Tinubu is my benefactor, my very own father. In 2010, Mr. Fashola, when asked about his relationship with Mr. Tinubu, he replied, "I don't have a godfather," insists rather, and refers to him as a political mentor. At the time, Fashola's relationship with Tinubu, his predecessor, was frustrating. It wasn't exactly clear what their disagreement was, but both men were locked in a cold war unspoken of. 11 years later, Mr. Fashola has come on the subject again, but now has a flip side to it, now advocating to the younger politicians the need to have a godfather, a guardian, if you want to call it that, an elderly politician. If you want to call him a godfather, that's not a wrong choice of word. In this game, young people have their works and the elders have their works, Fashola has said about his view on godfatherism in politics and BBC Yoruba. He said there is nothing absolutely wrong. I will advise every young person to get a godfather. According to the Minister of Works and Housing, godfatherism is a normal occurrence. If you don't have one at home, you will have one outside. You will have one directing you here and there. So there is absolutely nothing wrong. Speaking further in the interview, the former Lagos State governor said godfatherism was not peculiar to politics. So also in other professions, everybody have godfather. When asked if Tinubu is safe to say is his godfather, he said, yes, he's my mentor, my godfather. The same person 10 years ago who said no. And why there was Cold War was because the reality of Tinubu's demand began to stare him in the face. When he came, there were terms and conditions. I know, you know, when you are desperate, say, don't worry. Is it a contract? I give it to you. Is it this? I give it to you. But guess what? Along come what we call reality. And when reality began to stare him in the face, that he was not able to do anything because this person was ruling through him by proxy, he began to fight back. Fighting back was not the way forward. Oh yes, he began to fight back and say, ah, no. And so the Cold War began. Nobody can speak. Nobody's saying exactly what is happening, but there was war. Nobody was saying anything. Nobody was saying, oh, you did this, you did not do that. But we all know, that's what began to happen. They began to, you know, they began to, there was so much noise here and there. People could not really put a finger to it. But everybody knows it's an unspoken reality of what is on ground. So whether you like it or not, Godfatherism is real. It's happening largely in the parts of Nigeria, especially, you know, with some people who have built their tentacles around directing other people, ruling through them by proxy in the area of administration. This is the person to make the commission of this. So much so that Desmond Elliott has told Nigerians, told the youth, Tinubu is my godfather. Oh, I love him so much. He went to Edo State and told everybody, told everyone who cares to listen in Edo State. Say, well, Tinubu is my godfather. I cherish him so much. And there is nothing wrong if Oshomole wants to be a godfather in Edo State. And the people replied him saying, Edo no be Lagos. That was the slogan. So what are we talking about? The truth is coming out. You know, you can only hide it for so long. After a while, there is just this way it pops up, you see. It just comes out. It just comes out into the open and there is a knowing. And so this is what is happening. Fashola has finally accepted. Whether you like it or not, it may be your political benefactor, whatever name you want to give to it. I mean, it's still what it is. If there is still control, it was during Fashola last time that we saw that they built the Lekki Admiralty, the whole place, and Lagos State is owing, you know, this we have part of the Cold War, the reason for the Cold War. Lagos State is owing Tinubu for years. How Tinubu got the money to build that place, only God knows. But they are going to be paying him for a very long time. You know, probably when Fashola looked at the whole thing and said, for instance, this money was built by the state money. Why are you saying they have to pay you? Saying that so it be. It's the terms and conditions. The guy verse. But guess what? If you have signed the contract and you did not read what we call the terms and conditions in the small print, this is what you have to deal with. So now waiting they happen be this so. Now waiting they go. And they finally say, well, say, he accept. Welcome to Nigeria. It is what it is. Anyway, my people, now so the matter they reach us. What is the benefit of Godfatherism and what are the demerits? They are all staring us in the face. I will start with the demerit. The governor cannot efficiently, even if he has a heart, to work for the people. There will be no funds to do that. You know why? Because he will have to determine, the godfather will tell him who to give the contract to, what to do, how to do it. At the end of the day, the state, nothing is done. Leave us a comment. We really love to hear from you. Please don't forget to like us, share, subscribe. God bless you. Bye for now.